So I'm going to be doing a blade swap, and I'm going to put the black blade into the B20-200 with the starved sound capacitor and the white blade in the B20-301. So it'll be black and white, and then the other one will be white and black. So we're going to do this quick little blade swap, and then I'm going to get to recording more of the blue fans and the all the blue fans in my collection series. This video has nothing to do with that series. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get started.
Perfect, has to be perfect.
Now, I've done this once before with the blue fans you see over there in the corner, right over there next to the TV. Yeah, that's the blue one I always have on the table. That's the B2308. And if you can recall correctly, I put that blue blade in the B2200 at one time, and the white blade was in that one. Well, I don't want to tamper with that blue blade anymore because parts of it is kind of like chipped a little bit, and I don't want to take a chance of, you know, ruining that blade any worse than it is, because I'm trying not to come out of my pocket for a replacement. So I figure I'll just do, you know, the same thing with the black blade here. That blade is not ruined. So here we go.
Recommending things that I know work. Oof, you got two stop? That changes today. We're gonna go after another egg.
The egg weighs about 6 tons, so don't need the vessel that we got. It's got pain on the air to handle. Last is the warrior.
They're putting together a team of Dominion's top ranks for a scavenger hunt in search of an old family heirloom.
It's an anchor that the old man lost years and years ago.
Way back in the day, my father lost an anchor and recorded the coordinates.
A 5 or 6 ton anchor might be 10 or 15 grand if you had to go and buy one brand new.
What the word, Kirby, Sean, Robin, Lorray, this is a fun family hunt. What's this? Which means it can extend up to 15 meters, and even at full height, it could still lift 11 tons. But to support all that weight, a thick column extends all the way through the boat and connects to the shell plating.
It kind of makes the boat, because it just gives you the ability to handle stuff on that, overboarding large items. It's a really nice little system.
Once they arrive at the location of the long-gone anchor, they finally get this crane into action.
All right, let's see what we got. Might not be able to hear the wind stream, but it is moving a lot of air with that white blade. All right, spin down. The balance is superb. It's not falling over at full power. Spin down time is decent with the white blade. That is so cool, white and black. Pretty cool. Let's see what it looks like with black and white. So I'm gonna get that one together now and then we'll test it. I'm just making this all one video. I'm not editing the video.
Springs open when it's on the opposite side of the shackle that's on the anchor.
It's a spring-loaded hook that allows the rope, the buoy or the float, to be on the other side of the loop and come up. So the ROV's going to fly down, and Lorraine's going to stay up this unit. So back the ROV up, and we're going to be left with this, with a rope tied on the end here.
crew will then pull a 1-inch rope back through the shackle, finally tying rope number 3, which is actually a 1.5-inch steel cable.
That's up to a 50-ton winch. That is going to be our main lifting cable. Once we get that down through the shackle of the anchor, we can start bringing it back up with the anchor in tow.
From the control room, Larray flies Chinook down onto the ship.
Hey,
okay, I'm going in for it.
All right, that looks pretty cool, don't it? Black and white. There it is. Looks so cool. All right. So let's give it a test and see what it sounds like. Probably can't hear the windscreen, but it's moving quite a bit of wind. No, it's not falling over. That blade is definitely out of balance. You can kind of hear the starve sound somewhat transitioning when you change the speed. It is much quieter on low with that blade. Yeah, the windstream is decent. Let's get it back up to full power. All right, spin down.
My mental health was much better. I struggled with uncontrollable movements called TD, tardive dyskinesia.
Spin down time is decent. I hope the blade is balanced, don't go back and forth. All right, it didn't do that. Make sure you guys want to hear the strobe sound, so I'll try to capture it from the back. All right, let's try to capture it from the back. I wish it was a little bit more pronounced on the strobe sound, but can't really ask for anything more than that. At least it does have a strobe sound. Okay. Well, there you go. So that's that blade swap. And that's both of those fans. Was the blades going to stay that way? Well, for a while, they will stay that way. So I don't have any plans to switch the blades back. I kind of like the black and the white scheme with the gray housing. And the all-black scheme with the gray knob and gray handle and the white blade. So that's pretty cool. I'll keep it like that for a while. If I switch it back, you'll see a video on it. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this long video. Sorry for being long. The Mike Fan Man, God bless you and gone, and out.